The principle of superposition is an idea which comes up a lot in physics and math classes. And wherever you see it, it will usually mean about the same thing. And that is, you can generate new things from old things via superposition. So in this context, we're dealing with linear homogeneous differential equations. And what the principle of superposition says is that if we have two solutions of a linear homogeneous differential equation, y1 and y2, then we can add those two solutions together and scale them by constants c1 and c2. In other words, take a linear combination of those two solutions, and we get a new solution of the linear homogeneous differential equation. We could consider, for example, a second order linear homogeneous differential equation, which would have this form. Here a, b, and c are any functions at all of x, which is the independent variable, and y is our dependent variable. Now remember, it's linear because of the way that y appears in the equation. Y and its derivatives appear by themselves, multiplied only by these arbitrary functions of the independent variable. And it's homogeneous because there's a zero on the right-hand side. If I were to replace this zero with anything non-zero, it would no longer be homogeneous. Now, why is the principle of superposition true? Well, let's illustrate the principle for a general second-order linear differential equation, as I've written here. So I start off with y1 and y2, and I assume that they're solutions of this linear homogeneous differential equation. Now that means, by definition, that if I plug in y1 or y2 into the equation, then the equation is satisfied. Now what can I do with this information? Well, I want to show in the end that a linear combination of y1 and y2, c1 y1 plus c2 y2, is a solution to the differential equation. So it would be smart for me to try taking a linear combination of these two equations. So I take c1 times the first equation, and c1 times 0 on the right-hand side is 0, plus c2 times the second equation, and again c2 times 0 is still 0. Now let's distribute that c1 through the equation. So I put c1 next to y1 in all places, and c2 next to y2 in all places. Now I add them together and sort of collect all the terms. So I'll have a of x times the linear combination of the second derivatives of y1 and y2, plus b times the linear combination of the first derivatives of y1 and y2, plus c times the linear combination of the no derivatives. Now what can I do with these? Well, the property of the derivative is that it respects addition and multiplication by constants. So what I can actually do is pull the second derivative out of this entire sum, this linear combination, pull the first derivative out, and just leave this one like it is. So this equation becomes a of x times the second derivative of the quantity c1 y1 plus c2 y2, plus b times the first derivative of the quantity c1 y1 plus c2 y2, plus this guy. So what I found is, in fact, that this linear combination, c1 y1 plus c2 y2, is a solution of the original differential equation. And that followed from the fact that y1 and y2 are solutions of the differential equation, and the properties of the derivative respecting addition and scalar multiplication. Now I should point out that there's nothing special here about a second order linear homogeneous differential equation. This exact argument would go through for any order as long as the equation is linear and homogeneous. There's also nothing special about taking a linear combination of only two solutions. I could take a linear combination of any number of solutions, and this exact argument would still go through. Now, I have a question for you, and that is, what happens if the equation is not homogeneous? So let's consider replacing maybe this zero that I had on the right-hand side before with a 1. You could try replacing it with something else too, maybe an x. What happens? How does this argument fail?